I don't remember any of it. Nothing. I completely blacked out. I woke up like a week later in the hospital on life support. I don't remember any of it.
You all right?
Hey, Tammy.
Just give me a second.
Oh, yeah. We'll give you all the time you need.
2 months ago, I decided to go back to rehab. I weighed the most I've ever weighed.
717 pounds.
Lorena? This just don't feel good. I was here maybe less than 30 minutes and my oxygen level dropped. I had to be taken to the hospital. They put me in a medical induced coma.
While you were in the coma, did you know your family was there?
I could hear voices. I vaguely remember them holding my hand. I woke up like a week later. So the first person I text was a group text Amanda, Amy, and Chris. I like sent them a picture like, it's me. That's one of my first memories. I ended up in the hospital and I was septic. So, yeah, there's that. Sorry.
Do you remember anything?
Cute nurses.
The cute nurses? Well, as long as they took good care of you, that's all that matters. Yeah. So has your voice been, you've noticed it's a little bit more raspier from being intubated in your new trach, but it'll get better.
After I woke up, the aide came in, he mentioned the trach, and I looked at him like, what the hell? Why am I getting a trach if I'm, like, breathing on my own? They, you know, told me it was reassured that I had a clear line into my lungs. Something else happened. But I've had a rough time with it. They cut your throat open and they put like I call it a PVC pipe. I don't know what else to call it. But it's a tube and it's in your throat and it's about maybe that long and I get direct air, oxygen. There's some stuff I didn't even know that could happen, like getting everything stuck in your throat. If it gets too stuck, I have to be suctioned out.
Oh, did that come out?
Well, it's also scary. Something could get stuck in it. And my worst fear is not being able to breathe.
Are you glad to be back?
Yeah.
Do what you gotta do. Go home, have your surgery. Yeah. As long as you keep that in your mind.
It's been 4 weeks since I got back to rehab. I think me hitting my rock bottom has opened my eyes. I have to get better. This is my last chance. I just don't understand why God saved me again. This is why I didn't want to do this.
As a normal person only cheats death once.
I'm not normal.
You damn right you're not. Yeah, I know 3 or 4 times you done cheated death. So let's not try to push your luck no more.
I told y'all when y'all see me again, I wasn't gonna be that same person.
So do you feel like you're finally doing this because you want it and not because we're pressuring you to?
Yes. I'm not ready to give up. I'm telling you, this is it. I'm getting a surgery.
I want to believe Tammy has changed, but this is Tammy's fourth new chance on life. Because this is the second time that she's been on a ventilator for multiple days. So she's beat the odds two or three different times now. So my question is, when are you gonna quit playing Russian roulette and start making the changes you need to make? Tammy wanted me to bring flowers for all some of the nursing staff that have been taking care of her. We want to thank you very much for all the work y'all do.
Thank you. We appreciate this a lot.
Tammy, give me a call for me to get some flowers for the nurses. Which sounded not like Tammy, really, because last time she was there, she half-assed fought with everybody there.
Actually, we enjoy taking care of Tammy. We really do. She's been a good inspiration to a lot of the other patients here.
Well, that's great news because, you know, Tammy's had a rough go the last year.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully that's new signs of the way Tammy's going to be from now on. But honestly, the thing I'm worried about is the doctors in ICU told us Tammy was going to have a really long road to recovery. So she's the one that's got to make the changes. She's the one that's got to stick to it and do it. I hope Tammy keeps fighting for her life.
Tammy, are you okay? Are you okay?
Last night, I literally about died. I was laying there, I started coughing a lot. My oxygen dropped down to like 20. And then I got to where I couldn't breathe. By the time the nurse got in there, I was already blacking out. It was horrible. I could not breathe at all. Not out of my nose, not out of my mouth, nothing. I started panicking, literally panicking. An aide came in there and I was like trying to tell him. I couldn't talk. So, she ran and got the nurse. By the time the nurse got in there, I was about gone. Literally about gone. And the only thing I can remember is panicking, trying not to panic, but I couldn't breathe. And I felt like they were taking the time, but they really wasn't.
Tammy scared us all. She wasn't getting enough oxygen. Everybody came in running and tried everything they can to get her oxygen levels back up. We were able to suction the mucus plug out and she came back up.
As nasty as this is gonna sound, it's the truth. The mucus gets thick. And when it gets thick, it can get clogged or stuck into the tube. So basically, it's a booger. That's stuck. But I'm trying to make light of the situation because it's one way I cope with, scary crap, I guess.
We were very worried about you.
When I start coughing a lot, yeah, it does scare me. I never know if that's gonna happen again. It's terrifying, the not knowing what could happen next.